In this final lesson, we'll look at examples of complex Pi system architectures, as well as topics that arise when the Pi system has to adapt to large, intricate networks. It's common to find Pi system architectures spread across multiple networks. We saw in the beginning of this course diagrams of Pi interfaces in a process control network, with Pi server applications on a demilitarized zone, and Pi client users on a corporate network. So while our virtual learning environment consisted of just these four machines on the same Pi school network, this simple design is hardly the case. Here is an example of all the Pi data archives and Pi interfaces within one network, while clients and Pi AF server are on a separate one. No network firewalls get in the way of data flow from the Pi interfaces to the Pi collective. So the majority of security configuration between these two consists of just Pi trust and Pi mappings. One network-related concern is opening the right ports in the firewall to allow both Pi AF and client access to the Pi collective. Overall, the networks maintain a separation between the storage of real-time data on the left and then consumers of data on the right. In this next example, we take one of the Pi collective members out of the sensitive process control network and into the corporate network here. This could be for a number of reasons. For example, if the amount of network traffic coming from end users is too much for the process control network to handle, you may consider taking a Pi data archive out, like here. This can immediately provide better quality of service for the users, although you will have to take into consideration a different type of traffic between the firewalls, namely Pi collective synchronization, shown here, and N-way buffering, shown there. But this might be worth it, depending on the differences in network load with this architecture. In addition, this diagram shows that the domain controller, located here, isn't servicing the process control network, thus making this process control network a work group, as opposed to a domain. So Pi clients cannot use Pi mappings to connect to this Pi data archive. They'll need to stick to Pi trusts, which instead rely on machine names and IP addresses. In this next example, there are multiple domains involved, as seen by these two domain controllers. This could resemble a really large corporation with sites located in different regions. This presents the most significant challenge in terms of network routing and security so far. On the left-hand side, we see clients directly accessing the process control network for data, while on the right hand, it appears necessary to place a Pi data archive much closer to these users. Lastly, let's discuss some challenges with complex architectures. When it comes to Pi archives in a Pi collective, it's important to understand that individual Pi archive files are rarely identical among Pi collective members. Sure, the data on all the Pi archives as a whole will be the same, but the way Pi collective members handle and create new Pi archives individually may be different. A simple example is when one Pi data archive uses 256 megabyte sized Pi archive, while another uses, let's say, 512 megabyte Pi archives. The admins for this Pi system may have deviated from recommendations due to a lack of online hard drive space on the first Pi collective member. Or potentially, the backup solution for the first member is better suited to handle these smaller files. Another example is if maybe one Pi collective member has an issue with its current Pi archive And so the administrator has to stop it from using this PyArchive midway through and for it to start utilizing a brand new archive. Whatever the case, know that you can't just swap archive files between Pi Collective members. So it's essential that backups are made for the Pi archives for each member. Another challenge arises when the primary Pi Data Archive machine becomes permanently unavailable due to either a planned decommission or an unplanned disaster. In this scenario, you will want to take an existing secondary Pi Collective member and promote it to the primary role. While you may consider using Pi Collective Manager, there's a command line utility called PyRTool that makes it simple. For more information, refer to the High Availability Guide. Another topic with complex architectures is the use of network storage, like network attached storage and storage array networks. The PyData Archive, in fact, supports many styles of network storage. As always, make sure to conduct tests to ensure that data can be archived and read from these network storage locations at a suitable rate. Refer to this KB article for additional information and tips with Pi system support for network storage. If Pi interfaces are located far from Pi Data Archives, you should consider using disconnected startup, a feature of UniInt. Normally, Pi interfaces start up by first contacting the Pi Data Archive and querying for the set of Pi points they're responsible for updating. If the Pi Data Archive is far away from a network perspective, or if the number of Pi points is just gigantic, this step may take a long time. All the while, the Pi interface can't begin its true purpose, which is collecting data. The solution, disconnected startup, saves a copy of the Pi interface's Pi points locally on its own machine. When the Pi interface starts up, it uses this copy instead of asking the Pi Data Archive. While the Pi interface is operational, it'll detect any differences in the Pi point list and update its local cached version. For Pi systems that span multiple domains, it makes it a lot easier in terms of security and networking to make the domains trust one another. This kind of trust allows users from one domain to access services and resources in another domain. This, of course, has a wider range of effects outside of just the Pi system. But again, this is another trade-off decision between security and accessibility of resources. In this video, we looked at examples of complex Pi system architectures, typically consisting of multiple networks and domains, with firewalls to separate them. Depending on your own network, sensitivity of data, etc., consider if one or a combination of these will best suit your organization, spanning all the users who interact with the Pi system. In addition, there will be a number of architectural challenges when incorporating a new Pi system or adding power to an existing one. Take the lessons and examples from this course to help steer your planning and decisions.